So if you noticed, all three of these children that we discussed had something in common. We had three children who had a genetic disease in which both parents were seemingly healthy, but the child had the disease. However, the mechanisms behind these three diseases were actually different. So in the cases of Lorenzo and Massimo, there was actually a defective gene that both parents had, and unluckily, each parent passed down the broken version of the gene to the child, resulting in the disease. However, in the case of Sam, both parents actually had perfect copies of this lamin A gene, but Sam somehow had a mutated copy. So the distinction is two parents having broken copies that are recessive and passing down this broken recessive copy each, resulting in a child that has the disease, versus both parents having actually two perfect copies, but still having a child that somehow gets a mutation. And we actually cannot differentiate between these two mechanisms without sequencing the genome trio, the mother, father, and child. So some definitions. First, we want to talk about compound heterozygotes. So imagine both parents are carriers for some disease. In other words, they have one functional copy of a gene and one recessive broken copy of the gene. So with their dominant functional copy, they display the regular healthy phenotype, regular healthy characteristics, whereas this recessive broken copy just kind of hides away in the background. A compound heterozygote is a child who inherits two recessive broken copies, but these two broken copies are broken in different ways. So in this toy example, we have a father who has one healthy copy, the bottom version, and has one mutated copy, this red A, that's actually broken. And we also have the mother, who is in a similar situation, has one healthy copy, the top version, but has a broken copy in the bottom version. But her copy that's broken is broken differently. It has an A in the last position. And the child inherited each parent's broken copy, but within the child, now you have two different types of the broken copy. So the two copies are broken in different ways. So this child would be a compound heterozygote. So unlike the previous example in which both parents had a broken copy of the given gene, imagine a scenario where both parents actually have two functional copies of the given gene. However, one of the parents' gametes, or sex cells, has a new or de novo mutation. So then when the child is born, this gamete that gave rise to the child passes down this mutation to the child. So in this example, we have a mother who has two functional copies of this gene and passes down a functional copy to the child. But we have a father who also had two functional copies of a gene, but in the process of passing it down to the child, the gamete had a mutation at the second position that ended up breaking the gene. So now, even though the father had two functional copies, the child has one broken copy. So if this breaking, this mutation, is dominant, the child will have a disease.